For children with neuromuscular flatfoot, tone imbalance causes the forefoot to rotate externally, the calcaneus to rotate laterally, and the talonavicular joint to be uncovered, resulting in a limited range of motion and difficulty walking. To improve ankle dorsiflexion in children with spastic flatfoot, first, a recession of the gastrocnemius muscle is performed. An incision is made on the inside of the leg, where the muscle and the Achilles tendon meet. The gastrocnemius muscle is cut, taking care to avoid the soleus muscle below and the sural nerve laterally. The ankle is dorsiflexed, and the foot is held in this position so the gastrocnemius muscle can heal in a lengthened position onto the soleus muscle. For the calcaneal lengthening, an incision is made on the outside of the foot. Special care is taken to avoid harming the sural nerve. The peroneus brevis and peroneus longus are identified, and the peroneus brevis is lengthened. Next, the calcaneus is cut, and pins are placed on either side of the bone. Then the bone is wedged open. X-rays are taken with trial wedges to ensure the tailor head is covered as the calcaneus is lengthened. A piece of bone graft is placed into the opening, and the pins are removed. If the calcaneus is still in an abnormal position and is not corrected with the first two steps, then the posterior heel will be adjusted so it is in a more anatomic position. The incision on the outside of the foot is lengthened, then the calcaneus is cut. It is moved into a more central position and held in place with screws. The calcaneus is now in line with the tibia and the foot position is corrected. For more information, please visit the Children's Hospital Colorado's website.